بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. So we've reached the 25th sitting, alhamdulillah. So we're just continuing on from yesterday's lesson, and we've arrived at المجلس الخامس والعشرون في وصف النار أعاذنا الله منها. So the Shaykh says the 25th sitting regarding the description of the hellfire. And then the Shaykh mentions a dua here. He says supplication, and he says أعاذنا الله منها. May Allah that we seek refuge in Allah from it, i.e. from the fire, the hellfire. So then the Shaykh begins with his introduction, and he says Alhamdulillah al-qayyum al-baqi wa ghayruhu la yadum rafa as-samaa wa zayyanaha bin-nujum wa amsaka al-arda bi-jibalin fin-nukhum fit-tukhum sawwara bi-qudratihi hadhihi al-jusum thumma amataha wa mahar rusum ثم ينفخ في السور فإذا الميت يقوم ففريق إلى دار النعيم وفريق إلى نار السموم تفتح أبوابها في وجوههم لكل باب منهم جزء مقسوم وتوسد عليهم في عمد ممددة فيها للهموم والغموم يوم يغشاهم العذاب من فوقهم ومن تحت أرجلهم فما منهم مرحوم وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له شهادة من للنجاة يروم وأشهد أن محمد عبده ورسوله الذي فتح الله بدينه الفرس والروم صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان ما حطلت الغيوم وسلم تسليما. So then the Shaykh, he says, he begins with his introduction, as you've seen throughout each of the sittings, alhamdulillah. And he says, with the rough meaning of, all praises and thanks are due to Allah, the ever-living, the self-sufficient, the only one who will remain after everything else has perished. He raised up the sky and beautified it with the stars. He stabilized the earth with firm mountains. He fashioned the human body with his ability and then caused them to die and wiped out their form. Then the trumpet will be blown, and behold, these dead bodies will rise up, resurrected. Some of them will end up in the abode of bliss, and others will end up in the blazing fire. Its doors will be opened for them in categories, or in categorized. The doors will be categorized. Then the door closed on them in buildings of high pillars filled with sorrow and grief, on the day when they will be overshadowed with torment from above them and from beneath them. None of them will receive mercy. Then the Shaykh says, I testify that none has a right to be worshipped except Allah alone without a partner, the testimony of the one who desires salvation. I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a slave and messenger, and the one who Allah conquered with his religion, the Persians and the Roman empires. The peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, his family members, his companions, and whoever follows them in their footsteps, as long as the clouds continue to pour down rain. So then the Shaykh says, continues, start the chapter, alhamdulillah. He says, Ikhwani, lakad hadharan Allahu ta'ala في كتابه من النار وأخبرنا عن أنواع عذابها بما تتفطر منه الأكباد وتتفجر منه القلوب. حذرنا منها وأخبرنا عن أنواع عذابها رحمة بنا لنزداد حذرا وخوفا. أسمعوا ما جاء في كتاب الله تعالى وسنة رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم من أنواع عذابها لعلكم تذكرون. وأنيبوا إلى ربكم وأسلموا له من قبل أن يأتيكم العذاب ثم لا تنصرون. So let's just translate that inshallah first, because we're going to go into a series of ayahs that we're going to read and then get the translation for inshallah. So then the Shaykh, he says, oh my brothers, Allah the Most High has warned us in his book against the punishment of the hellfire and about the hellfire. And he has informed us of the different kinds of punishment which cause livers to split and hearts to explode. Out of his mercy, he has informed us so that perhaps we will take caution and be afraid of it. Therefore, listen to some of what has been mentioned in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah of his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam regarding the different types of punishments with regards to the hellfire, so that perhaps, you know, we may reflect. So he says, turn to your Lord in repentance and submit to his will before the punishment comes to you, and you will not have anyone to help. You won't be helped. So Allah said, so we'll read, we'll do what we did a couple of lessons ago, where I read through all of the ayat of the Quran, and then we went through all the translations. That'd be easy, inshallah. Barakallahu feekum. So then the Shaykh says, قال الله تعالى واتقوا النار التي أعدت للكافرين إن أعتدنا للكافرين سلاسل وأغلالا وسعيرا. وقال تعالى إن أعتدنا للظالمين نارا أحاط بهم سرادقها. وقال تعالى مخاطبا إبليس إلا من اتبعك من الغاوين وإن جهنم لموعدهم أجمعين لها سبعة أبواب لكل باب منهم جزء مقسوم. وقال تعالى وسيق الذين كفروا إلى جهنم زمرا حتى إذا جاءوها فتحت أبوابها. وقال تعالى وللذين كفروا بربهم عذاب جهنم وبئس المصير تكاد تميز من الغيظ. وقال تعالى يوم يغشاهم العذاب من فوقهم ومن تحت أرجلهم. وقال تعالى لهم من فوقهم ظلل من النار ومن تحتهم ظلل ذلك يخوف الله به عباده يا عباد فاتقون. وقال تعالى وأصحاب الشمال ما أصحاب الشمال في سموم وحميم وظل من يحموم لا بارد ولا كريم. وقال تعالى وقالوا لا تنفروا في الحر قل نار جهنم أشد حرا. وقال تعالى وما أدراك ما هي نار حامية. وقال تعالى إن المجرمين في ضلال وسعر يوم يسحبون في النار على وجوههم ذوقوا مس سقر. وقال تعالى وما أدراك ما سقر لا تبقي ولا تذر لواحة للبشر. وقال تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا قوا أنفسكم وأهليكم نار وقودها الناس والحجارة عليها ملائكة غلاظ شداد لا يعصون الله ما أمرهم ويفعلون ما يؤمرون. وقال تعالى إنها ترمي بشرر كالقصر كأنه حمالة صفر. وقال تعالى وترى المجرمين يومئذ مقرنين في الأصفاد سرابيلهم من قطران وتغشى وجوههم النار. وقال تعالى إذ الأغلال في أعناقهم وسلاسل يسحبون في الحميم يسحبون في الحميم ثم في النار يسجرون. وقال تعالى: فالذين كفروا قطعت لهم ثياب من نار يصب من فوق رؤوسهم الحميم يسحر به ما في بطونهم والجلود ولهم مقامع من حديد كلما أرادوا أن يخرجوا منها من غم أعيدوا فيها وذوقوا عذاب الحريق. وقال تعالى: إن الذين كفروا بآياتنا سوف نصليهم نارا كلما نضجت جلودهم بدلناهم جلودا غيرها ليذوقوا العذاب. وقال تعالى: إن شجرة الزقوم طعام الأثيم كالمهل يغلي في البطون كغلي الحميم. وقال في تلك الشجرة: إنها شجرة تخرج في أصل الجحيم تلعها كأنه رؤوس الشياطين. وقال تعالى: ثم إنكم أيها الضالون المكذبون لآكلون من شجر من زقوم فمالئون منها البطون فشاربون عليه من الحميم فشاربون شرب الهيم هذا نزلهم يوم الدين. وقال تعالى: وإن يستغيثوا يغاثوا بماء كالمهل يشوي الوجوه بئس الشراب وساءت مرتفقا. وقال تعالى: وسقوا ماء حميما فقطع أمعاءهم. وقال تعالى: ويسقى من ماء سديد يتجرعه ولا يكاد يسيغه ويأتيه الموت من كل مكان وما هو بميت ومن ورائه عذاب غليظ. وقال تعالى: إن المجرمين في عذاب جهنم خالدون لا يفتر عنهم وهم فيه مبلسون وما ظلمناهم ولكن كانوا هم الظالمون ونادوا يا مالك ليقضي علينا ربك قال إنكم ماكثون. وقال تعالى: مأواهم جهنم كلما خبت زدناهم سعيرا. وقال تعالى: إن الذين كفروا وظلموا لم يكن الله ليغفر لهم ولا ليهديهم طريقا إلا طريق جهنم خالدين فيها أبدا وكان ذلك على الله يسيرا. وقال تعالى: وحيل بينهم وبين ما يشتهون كما فئل بأشياعهم من قبل إنهم كانوا في شك مريب. وقال تعالى: ومن يأس الله ورسوله فإن له نار جهنم خالدين فيها أبدا. وقال تعالى: وما أدراك ما الحطمة نار الله الموقدة التي تطلع على الأفئدة إنها عليهم مؤصدة في عمد ممددة. والآيات في وصف النار وأنواع عذابها الأليم الدائم كثيرة. I'll pull these up inshallah and then we'll go through the translations of each ayah bi'idhnillahi ta'ala. Give me a second. Okay, so we'll go one by one inshallah. So the first ayah: and fear the fire which has been prepared for the disbelievers. Ali Imran, verse 131. Verily we have prepared for the disbelievers chains and iron collars and a blazing fire. Al-Insan, verse 4. We have prepared for the wrongdoers a fire whose flaming canopy shall enclose them. Al-Kahf, verse 29. Surely thou shalt have no power over my servants except such of the early ones as choose to follow. And surely hell is a promised place for them all. It has seven gates and each gate has a portion of them allotted to it. Al-Hijr 42-44. and those who disbelieve will be driven to hell in troops or in groups until when they arrive there, its gates will be opened. Surah Az-Zumar, verse 71. And for those who disbelieve in their Lord is a punishment of hell, and an evil resort it is. When they are cast therein, they will hear it roaring as it boils up. Surah Al-Mulk, verse 6 to 7. On the day when the punishment will overwhelm them from above them and from underneath their feet, he will say, taste the fruit of your actions. Al-Ankabut, verse 55. They will have over them coverings of fire and beneath them similar coverings. It is this against which Allah warns his servant, O my servants, fear me. Az-Zumar, verse 16. And those on the left hand, how unfortunate are those on the left hand, they will be in the midst of scorching winds and scalding water, and under the shadow of pitch black smoke, neither cool nor wholesome. Surah Al-Waqi'ah, verse 42 to 44. They said, go not forth in the heat, say the fire of hell is more intense in heat, if only they could understand. At-Tawbah, verse 81. And what should make you know what that is? It is a blazing fire. Surah Al-Qari'ah, verse 10 to 11. Surely the guilty are in manifest error and suffer from madness. On the day when they will be dragged into the fire on their faces, it will be said to them, taste the touch of hell, or taste hell. Surah Al-Qamar, verse 47 to 48. Soon shall I cast him into the fire of hell, and what will make you know what hellfire is? It spares not and it leaves not. Surah Al-Mudathir, verse 26 to 28. O you who believe, save yourselves and your families from a fire whose fuel is men and stones, over which are appointed angels, stern and severe, who do not disobey Allah in what he commands them with, and do as they are commanded. Surah At-Tahrim, verse 6. It throws up sparks like huge castles, as if they were tawny camels. Surah Al-Mursalat, verse 32 to 33. And you'll see the guilty on that day bound in chains. Their garments will be of pitch, and fire shall envelop their faces. Surah Ibrahim, 49 to 50. When the iron collars will be round their necks and chains as well, and they will be dragged into boiling water, then in the fire will they be burnt. Surah Al-Ghafir, verse 71 to 72. These two opponents, the believers and disbelievers, dispute with each other about their Lord. As for those who disbelieve, garments of fire will be cut out for them, and boiling water will be poured down over their heads, whereby that which is in their bellies and their skins too will be melted. And for them are hooked rods of iron to punish them. Every time they seek to get away therefrom, from anguish, they will be driven back therein, and it will be said to them, taste the torment of burning. Al-Hajj, verse 90 to 22. Those who disbelieve in our signs, we shall soon cause them to enter the fire. As often as their skins are burnt up, we shall give them in exchange new skins, that they may continue to taste the punishment. Surely Allah is mighty and wise. Surah An-Nisa, verse 56. Indeed, the tree of Zakum is food for the sinful. Like murky oil, it boils within the bellies, like the boiling of scalding water. Ad-Dukhan, verse 43 to 46. Verily, it is. And then the Shaykh says, with regards to the tree further in this description, then he quotes this ayah. He says, verily, it is a tree that springs out of the bottom of hellfire. The shoots of its fruits stalk like the heads of devils. Surah As-Saffat, verse 64 to 65. Allah the Most High mentioned about the tree in another chapter as well. He says here in the translation of, then moreover, verily you, the erring ones, the deniers of resurrection, you will eat of the tree of Zakum. Then you will fill your bellies therewith and drink boiling water on top of it. So you will drink that like thirsty camels. That will be their entertainment on the day of recompense. Surah Al-Waqiyah, verse 51 to 56. And if they ask for help, relief or water, etc., they will be granted water like boiling oil, which will scald their faces. Terrible the drink, and what an evil dwelling resting place, etc. That's Surah Al-Kahf, verse 29. And be given to drink boiling water so that it cuts up their intestines. Surah Muhammad, verse 15. In front of him, every obstinate, arrogant dictator is hell, and he will be made to drink boiling, festering water. He will sip it unwillingly, and he will find a great difficulty to swallow it down his throat, and death will come to him from every side. Yeah, he will not die, and in front of him will be a great torment. Surah Ibrahim, verse 16 to 17. Verily, the mujrimun, criminals, sinners, disbelievers, etc., will be in the torment of hellfire. Of hell to abide therein forever. The torment will not be lightened for them, and they will be plunged into destruction with deep regrets, sorrows, and in despair therein. We wronged them not, but they were the zalimun, polytheists, wrongdoers, etc. And they will cry, O Malik, O keeper of hell, let your Lord make an end of us. He will say, verily you shall abide therein forever, in the hellfire forever. Surah Az-Zukhruf, verse 74 to 77. And we shall gather them together on the day of resurrection, on their faces, blind, dumb, deaf, dumb, and blind. Their abode will be hell. Whenever it abates, we shall increase for them the fire, fierceness of the fire. Surah Al-Isra, verse 97. Verily, those who disbelieve and did wrong, Allah will not forgive them, nor will He guide them to any way except the way of hell, to dwell therein forever. And this is ever easy for Allah. Surah An-Nisa, verse 168-169. Allah has cursed the disbelievers and prepared for them a blazing fire. Surah Al-Ahzab, verse 64. My responsibility is only to convey what is revealed to me from Allah and His messages. And those who disobey Allah and His messenger, surely for them is the fire of hell, wherein they will abide for a long period. Surah Al-Jinn, verse 23. Nay, verily, he will be thrown into the crushing fire. And what will make you know what the crushing fire is? The fire of Allah kindled, which leaps up over the hearts. Verily, it shall be closed in on them in pillars stretched forth, i.e. they will be punished in the fire with pillars, etc. Surah Al-Humazah, verse 4 to 8. So then the Shaykh says, there are many verses like this in the Quran describing the hellfire and its painful punishments. And then the Shaykh says, and what follows from here onwards are some narrations from the Prophet ﷺ about the description of the hellfire as well and its severe torments. So what we'll do is, we'll just go through each hadith one by one and translate it so we can keep up, inshallah. So bear with me. So then the Shaykh says, وَالْآيَاتُ فِي وَصْفِ النَّارِ وَأَنْوَاعِ عَذَابِهَا الْأَلِيمُ الدَّائِمُ كَثِيرًا. So we read that already. أما الأحاديث فعن عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال يؤتى بالنار يوم القيامة لها 70,000 زمام مع كل زمام 70,000 ملك يجرونها رواه مسلم. So the first hadith been narrated by Abdullah ibn Mas'ud رضي الله عنه, that he said that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the hellfire will be brought on the day of judgment with 70,000 rains. With each rain, there are 70,000 angels pulling it like a rope, pulling it. And then the Shaykh says, he says, Rawahu Muslim, so collected by Muslim. So then we move on to the next hadith. The Shaykh says, وَفِي الصَّحِيحَيْنِ عَنْ أَبِي هُرَيْرَةَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ أَنَّ النَّبِيَّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ قَالَ نَارُكُمْ هَذِهِ مَا يُوقَدُ بَنُوا آدَمَ جُزْءٌ وَاحِدٌ مِنْ سَبْعِينَ جُزْءًا مِنْ نَارِ جَهَنَّمْ قَالُوا يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِنَّهَا لَكَافِيَةٌ قَالَ إِنَّهَا فُصِّلَتْ عَلَيْهَا بِتِسْعَةٍ وَسِتِّينَ جُزْءًا كُلُّهُنَّ مِثْلُ حَرِّهَا. So let's read the, let's get the translation of that, inshallah, and translate that. So then this is a narration narrated by Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu that the Prophet said, this fire of yours, which the sons of Adam light, is a single part from the 70 parts of the hellfire. They said, O Messenger of Allah, indeed this fire is hot enough for us. The Prophet said, the fire of hell is 69 times hotter than this fire. So let's carry on. Then the Shaykh, he says, وَعَنْهُ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ قَالَ كُنَّا عِنْدَ النَّبِي صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ فَسَمِئْنَا وَجْبَةً فَقَالَ النَّبِي صلى الله عليه وسلم أَتَدْرُونَ مَا هَذَا قُلْنَا اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَعْلَمْ قَالَ هَذَا حَجْرٌ أَرْسَلَهُ اللَّهُ في جهنم منذ 70 خريفا يعني 70 سنة فالآن حين انتهى إلى قعرها رواه مسلم. So then also narrated by Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, he said here that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, we were with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam one day when we heard a booming sound. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, do you know what this sound is? We said, Allah and His Messenger know best. He said, this is a rock which Allah sent in the hellfire from 70 autumns ago, meaning 70 years ago. It has just landed to the bottom of the hellfire, collected by a Muslim. Let's carry on. So then the Shaykh, he says, let's find where that is now. We're going too far. Then the Shaykh says, وقال عتبة بن غزوان رضي الله عنه وهو يخطب لقد ذكر لنا أن الحجر يلقى من شفير جهنم فيهوي فيها 70 عاما ما يدرك لها قعرا والله لتعلمن أو لتملأن أفعجبتم فعجبتم رواه مسلم. So then the Shaykh quotes a narration by Utbah ibn Ghazwan radiallahu anhu. He said, the Prophet said, certainly it has been mentioned to us that a rock, so he said that he from himself, he said, certainly it has been mentioned to us that a rock will be thrown from the edge of the hellfire and it will tumble in it for 70 years before reaching its bottom. By Allah, the hellfire will be filled up. Are you all amazed by this? And that's collected by Muslim. Then the Shaykh continues and he says, وَعَنْ إِبْنُ عَبَّاسِ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمَا أَنَّ النَّبِيَ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ قَالَ لَوْ أَنَّ قَطْرَةً مِنَ الزَّقُومِ قَطَرَتْ فِي دَارِ الدُّنْيَا لأفسدت على أهل الدنيا معايشهم رواه النسائي وترمذي وابن ماجه. So then the Shaykh mentions another hadith, and this is narrated by Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma. So he says, is narrated by Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if a tiny piece from the tree of Zakum dropped in this world, it would destroy the livelihood of the inhabitants of the earth. This has been graded authentic by Al-Albani in Sahih Al-Jami. Let's carry on. Then the Shaykh mentions another narration. He says, وَعَنِ النُّعْمَانِ بْنُ بَشِيرِ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ قَالَ أَنَّ النَّبِيَّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ قَالَ إِنَّ أَهْوَنَ أَهْلَ النَّارِ عَذَابًا مَنْ لَهُ نَعْلَانِ وَشِرَاكَانِ من نار يغلي منهما دماغه كما يغلي المرجل ما يرى أن أحدا أشد منه عذابا وإنه لأهونهم أو لأهونهم عذابا رواه مسلم وللبخاري نحوه. So then the Shaykh mentioned narration by Nu'man ibn Bashir رضي الله عنه. He said the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the one who will receive the least punishment of the hellfire will have two sandals from fire that will cause his brain to boil like the boiling of hot water in a pot. he will think that he is receiving the worst punishment, even though he is receiving the least punishment. Collected by Al-Bukhari and Muslim. Let's carry on. Then the Shaykh says, وَعَنْ أَنَسِ بْنُ مَالِكَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ أَنَّ النَّبِي صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ قَالَ يُؤْتَى بِأَنْعَمَ أَهْلِ الدُّنْيَا مِنْ أَهْلِ النَّارِ فَيُصْبَغُ فِي النَّارِ صِبْغَةً ثُمَّ يُقَالْ يَبْنَ آدَمَ هَلْ رَأَيْتَ خَيْرًا قَطُّ هَلْ مَرَّ بِكَ نَعِيمٌ قَطُّ فَيَقُولُ لَا وَاللَّهِ يَا رَبِّ وَيُؤْتَى بِأَشَدِّ النَّاسِ بُؤْسًا فِي الدُّنْيَا مِنْ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ فَيُصْبِغُ صِبْغَةً فِي الْجَنَّةِ فَيُقَالْ يَا ابْنَ آدَمَ هَلْ رَأَيْتَ بُؤْسًا قَطْ هَلْ مَرَّ بِكَ مِنْ شِدَّةِ قَطْ فَيَقُولُ لَا وَاللَّهِ يَا رَبِّي مَا رَأَيْتُ بُؤْسًا وَلَا مَرَّ بِي مِنْ شِدَّةٍ قَطْ رَوَاهُ مُسْلِمٌ يَعْنِي أَنَّ أَهْلَ النَّارِ يَنْسُونَ كُلَّ نَعِيمٍ مَرَّ بِهِمْ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَأَهْلُ الْجَنَّةِ يَنْسَوْنَ كُلَّ بُؤْسٍ مَرَّ بِهِمْ فِي الدُّنْيَا. So then the Shaykh says, and he quotes a narration by Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, who said that the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the most comfortable person in this world from the disbelievers will be brought on the day of judgment and will be dipped in the hellfire, and then it will be said to him, did you ever see good? Did you ever experience comfort before? And he will reply saying, no, by Allah, oh my Lord. And the most uncomfortable person in this world from the people of paradise will be brought and will be dipped in paradise and will be said to him, have you ever seen any hardship or experienced any adversities? He will say, by Allah, no, oh my Lord. Collected by Muslim. And the meaning of that is that the person who ends up in the hellfire, you know, he will forget. He will forget all of his all of the blessings, right? And the person who ends up in paradise, in with regards to the dunya, he will forget all of the hardships that he had in the dunya. So that's the meaning there. And then it's also narrated by Anas ibn Malik as well. So we'll read this in Arabic. وَعَنْهُ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ أَنَّ النَّبِيَّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ قَالَ يُقَالُ لِلرَّجُلِ مِنْ أَهْلِ النَّارِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَرَأَيْتَ لَوْ كَانَ لَكَ مَعَ الْأَرْضِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ أكنت تفتدي به فيقول نعم قال فيقول قد أردت منك ما هو أهون من ذلك قد أخذت عليك في ظهر آدم أن لا تشرك بي شيئا فأبيت إلا أن تشرك بي رواه أحمد ورواه البخاري ومسلم بنحوه ورواه ابن مردوي عن يألى ابن منية وهو ابن أمية ومنية أمه قال. So we'll just stop there for a second. So then the Shaykh mentions another narration by Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, and he says that the Prophet ﷺ said, it will be said to a man from the people of the hellfire on the day of judgment, if you possessed all that is on the earth, would you ransom yourself with it? He will say yes. Then Allah will say to him, I asked you for what is less than that. I have taken a covenant with you from the back of Adam that you will not associate partners with me, but you refused to accept but associate partners with me. Narrated by Ahmad, Al-Bukhari, Muslim, and also a similar narration. Then we'll mention this by Ibn Mardawiyah as well. So give me a second. Let's just pull out. So then the Shaykh mentions another a narration by Ibn Mardawiyah. He says, "Yunshi Allah li ahli nari sahabatan fa'idh ashrafat alayhim nadahum ya ahli nari ayu shay'in tatlubuna wa man ladhi tas'aluna fayadhkuruna biha sahaib al-dunya wal ma alladhi kana yanzilu alayhim فيقولوا نسأل يا رب الشراب فيمطرهم أغلالا تزيد في أغلالهم وسلاسل تزيد في سلاسلهم وجمرا يلهب النار عليهم. سبحان الله. So then the Shaykh mentions another narration, and he says Allah will send a cloud above the people of hell When the cloud approaches them, he will call them and say, O people of the hell, what is it that you are seeking? What is it that you are asking? And they will remember that when they were in the world, they used to get rain from the clouds. So they will say, O our Lord, we are asking you for drinking water. So he will send upon them collars and chains in addition to the ones they already have, and coals of fire, which increase the blazing of the blaze of the fire. And then it just mentions here there's a weak narration collected by Al-Haythami in Mujma' al-Zawaid. So then let's continue. Then the Sheikh says, وَعَنْ أَبِي مُوسَى رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ أَنَّ النَّبِي صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ قَالَ ثَلَاثَةٌ لَا يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةَ مُدْمِنُ خَمْرٍ وَقَاطِئُ رَحِمٍ وَمُصَدِّقُ بِالسِّحْرِ وَمَنْ مَاتَ مُدْمِنَ الْخَمْرِ سَقَاهُ اللَّهُ مِنْ نَهْرِ الْغَوْطَةِ قِيلَ وَمَا نَهْرُ الْغَوْطَةِ قَالَ نَهْرٌ يَجْرِي مِنْ فُرُوجِ المومسات يؤذي أهل النار ريح فروجهن رواه أحمد. So then the Sheikh mentions a narration by Abu Musa radiallahu anhu that the Prophet said there are three people who will not enter paradise: the alcoholic, the one who severs family ties, and the one who affirms magic. The one who dies while addicted to alcohol will be given to drink from the river of Ghouta. It was asked, what is the river of Ghouta? He said, it is a river in hell made from the discharge of the prostitutes. The smell of their private parts harms the people of the hellfire. Sheikh Al-Albani graded it to be weak in Daif al-Jami'. And let's carry on. Then the Shaykh says, وَفِي صَحِيحِ مُسْلِمِ عَنْ جَابِرِ بْنُ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمَا أَنَّ النَّبِيَّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ قَالَ إِنَّ عَلَى اللَّهِ أَهْدًا لِمَنْ مِنْ شَرِبَ الْمُسْكَرَاتِ لِيَسْقِيهِ مِنْ تِينَةِ الْخِبَالِ أو خَبَالِ. قَالُوا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَمَا تِينَةُ الْخَبَالِ؟ قَالَ أَرْقُ أَهْلِ النَّارِ أو وصارة أهل النار. وفي الصحيحين عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال يقال لليهود والنصارى ماذا تبغون؟ فيقولون عطشنا ربنا فأسقنا فيشار إليهم ألا تريدون؟ فيحشرون إلى جهنم كأنهم سراب يحتم بعضها بعضا فيتساقطون في النار. قال الحسن ما ظنك بقوم قاموا على أقدامهم 50,000 سنة سنة لم يأكلوا فيها أكلة ولم يشربوا فيها شربة حتى انقطعت أعناقهم عطشا واحترقت أجوافهم جوعا ثم انصرف بهم إلى النار فيسقون من عين آنية قد آن حرها واشتد نضجها. So let's go through that then. Then the Sheikh, he mentions a narration by Jabir ibn Abdullah, may Allah have mercy upon both of them, be pleased with both of them. The Prophet ﷺ said, Allah has taken a covenant with those who consume intoxicants that he will make them drink from the mud of Khabal. They said, O Messenger of Allah, what is the mud of Khabal? He said, it is the sweat of the people of the hellfire or the excrement of the people of the hellfire. Collected by Muslim. Also reported by the Prophet ﷺ, also reported, is said here, it will be said to the Jews and the Christians, what do you want? And they will say in reply, oh, our Lord, we are thirsty. Give us some drink. Then the hellfire will be pointed at, and it will be said to them, will you not go and get some drink from there? Then all of them will be gathered and dragged to the hellfire as if they are a mirage. They will be crushed. They will be crushing on one another till they fall into the hellfire. Collected by Al-Bukhari and Muslim. Then Al-Hasan said, what do you think of the people who stand on their feet for 50,000 years? They did not eat any food nor drink any water, to the point that their necks start to split due to the thirst, this extreme thirst, and their bellies start to burn due to extreme hunger. Then they will afterwards be taken to the hellfire and will be given drink from boiling water. So let's carry on. We're nearly finished, I think, inshallah. Let me just have a quick look. Yeah, we just got half a page. Bear with me, inshallah. وقال ابن الجوزي رحمه الله في وصف النار دار قد خص أهلها بالبعاد وحرموا لذة المنى والإسعاد بدلت وضاءة وجوههم بالسواد وضربوا بمقامع أقوى من الأطواد عليها ملائكة غلاظ شداد لو رأيتهم في الحميم سرحون وعلى الزمحرير يطرحون فحزنهم دائم فما يفرحون مقامهم محتوم فما يبرحون أبد الآباد عليها ملائكة غلاظ شداد يبكون على تضييع أوقات الشباب وكلما جاد البكاء زاد عليها ملائكة غلاظ شداد يا حسرتهم لغضب الخالق يا محنتهم لعظم البوائق يا فضيحتهم بين الخلائق على رؤوس الأشهاد أين كسبهم للحطام أين سعيهم في الآثام كأنه كان أدغاث أحلام ثم أحرقت تلك الأجسام وكلما أحرقت تعاد عليها ملائكة غلاظ شداد. So then the Sheikh mentions some sayings of Ibn al-Jawzi rahimahullah, may Allah have mercy upon him, in his description of the hellfire. It is an abode in which its dwellers are outcast. They are deprived of life, sweetness, and happiness. The brightness of their faces are replaced with dimness, darkness, and they will be hit with whips stronger than mountains. Its guards are angels who are stern and severe. And if you were to see one of these people being dragged in the boiling water and flung and tossed into this severe frost, you will see them constant grief. Their spots in the hellfire are inescapable. Its guards are angels who are stern and severe. Their scolding is more severe than the actual punishment. Their regret is more intense than the calamity that has befallen them. They cry for not taking advantage of the years when they were in their youth in the dunya. And whenever they increase in their mourning, the stern angels will increase in their punishment. It is very unfortunate for them that the anger of the Creator is over them. How very unfortunate it is for them to be in the midst of this test, filled with enormous catastrophes, very embarrassing for them amongst all the creatures to be disgraced in their presence. Where is their earning of the worthless debris of the worldly life? Where is their effort in the disobedience of their Lord? It is as if it all was nothing more than mixed up false dreams. Then these bodies will be burnt, and whenever they are burnt, their skins will be replaced for them. Its guards are stern and severe angels. So then the Sheikh closes with a supplication, and he says, اللهم نجينا من النار وعذنا من دار الخزي والبوار وأسكننا برحمتك دار المتقين الأبرار واغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولجميع المسلمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. So the rough translation of that is, O Allah, grant us protection from the hellfire and protection from the home of disgrace and destruction. O Allah, admit us with your mercy into the abode of the pious and the righteous ones. With your mercy, forgive us, our parents, and all of the Muslims. You are the most merciful. We ask Allah to shower his blessings and mercy on our Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam Muhammad, his family members, and all his companions. So alhamdulillah, we conclude there, and inshallah we'll continue tomorrow. And we only have a few lessons left now as we approach the end of Ramadan. So stay with us, inshallah, to benefit fully from this book. Barakallahu feekum. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta wa astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.